Today I was flying my Avata around this train bridge. I was trying to film a pass through the bridge and then under it. I've flown this before in normal mode, but I had the idea today that it would look better if I did it in sport mode. It wasn't my best idea today. Now my drone is out there somewhere and it's underwater. I don't know how deep it is out there, but I'm going to try swimming for it. I remember roughly where it went in, but I went into my goggles for what they call the last view before loss. I went to settings and then safety. It shows the final 30 seconds prior to your drone disconnecting if you crash it or sink it. I've watched that footage 8 or 10 times, and I know the view in front shows exactly how the bridge lines up with the tree line and this hydro pole. I'm looking at the side too, and I see the pole lining up with the white sign on shore. I just went and got my snorkel gear. If I can find a spot where the two sight lines intersect, then I'll be roughly at the point where the drone hit the water. There's a slight current, so the drone must have drifted downriver, and it's going to be hard to predict how much drifting it did as it sank. We're going on about 3 hours since I lost it, but the light is going to get dim pretty soon. Now I've been swimming for about 90 minutes, and the depth here is 8 to 10 feet. Visibility isn't bad. I've seen lots of fish, bass, carp. The bottom is pretty clear. It shouldn't be too hard to see the drone if I can just find the right spot. Oh, there it is. The drone was off when I found it, but it turned back on when I went to the surface, and the propellers gave a little shudder and the drone beeped. But I pulled the battery out as soon as I got to shore, and I shook out the drone, and then I had another idea. I drove home with the drone out the window a little bit to let the wind dry it out. As soon as I got home, I put in a claim, and it got approved within minutes. It cost me $29 for a new drone and a battery. Hard to beat that.